it fell into my jacket and they pumped 3 gallons of red Karo syrup into my underwear. I was murdered by the Ghostface Killer. I was supposed to be protecting Sidney Prescott, but I failed miserably because at a stoplight, the killer punched through the window and sliced my neck from ear to ear. I gagged on my own blood, dying. I really wanted to die with my eyes open because I'd always seen that as a little kid in horror movies and I thought it was really cool. So I got to do the whole and then that was super fun. Blood was supposed to come through my fingertips. So when I brought my hand up, I had a little sponge filled with red Karo syrup that I was supposed to squeeze and it was supposed to come through my fingers. But Wes wanted to see more blood. Unfortunately, my hand was still sticky from the first take and the tape that was holding the tube came undone. So as I brought it up, it fell into my jacket and they pumped 3 gallons of red Karo syrup into my underwear. You know, they hinted in the movie that he may or may not be gay. I think he was. I just think it was the 90s, so it wasn't that easy to be out at work. I'd like to think that he'd be living his best life. He'd be promoted to a cushy office job. He'd be married to his male life partner. They'd have a couple kids and a dog. And they'd watch the Drew Barrymore Show, of course. I really love a chocolate chip cookie, but when those weren't available, pretty much anything chocolate will do. Kit Kat, Twix, Toblerone, always get me through.